This is the second time I have recorded this reaction video.
When I downloaded the movie, it came with subtitles. But the twist is, they were Polish subtitles, not American subtitles. So then I had to go back to some torrent sites that specialize in subtitles and find the right subtitles, right? And I did that, kind of, but the subtitles were just choppy and ill-translated. I couldn't fuck with it. The lead actress is Polish. The lead actor is Italian. So when I downloaded the subtitles, there were only English translations for Italian. So whenever this bitch was by herself or with her friends, who were also all Polish, there were no subtitles. You had to fucking guess what was going on the entire time. And instead of getting some really good commentary out of it, it was just fucking aggravating. But I still got the reaction finished, though I didn't feel too confident in my product. So I was like, fuck it, let me search around just a little more to find some better subtitles. And lo and behold, after maybe the 10th fucking link, I found the best possible subtitles. And that's what brings me here, frustrated but also kind of relieved, at midnight, rewatching 365 Days. So my pseudo-perfectionist brain forced me to re-record this entire reaction because I couldn't stand that my jokes were lacking for 30% of the movie. I wasn't having it. Getting off that, we're watching 365 Days. Now, if you don't know what that is, that is a fuck movie. It's a Polish fuck movie. And on top of that, it's the very first Polish fuck movie. Like, I mean, I saw JXE tweet about this movie like a couple weeks back, and I was like, I could watch this. I can't get on board with this. So I looked it up. I skimmed through the first 13 minutes and I was like, oh yeah, this is, oh shit. This will not go unnoticed on my channel. Fuck that. Not to mention the movie is very popular on Netflix, apparently. You know, you never know with Netflix. They don't really release their numbers, so we don't really know. It's even led to a little outrage from a few Karens. One in particular wanting to get it removed from Netflix. So yeah, you know, if a Karen wants to get it removed from Netflix, it must not be that controversial. Let's just watch it. Let's get it over. I'm gonna complain about all the Karens and all the puritanical bullshit surrounded by this movie at a later time during the reaction, or probably at the end. I don't know. All right, let's click that play button. Let's do it. Oh, just beautiful sky, the Mediterranean, and a house that looks like a fucking abandoned slaughterhouse.
Ci sono circa 20 rifugiati. Alcune appena 12 anni. Ma il merce è buono. Un affare.
Yeah, the 12-year-old ass we're peddling. It's a good product. It's primo stuff, a big money maker.
Io temo che voi avete sbagliato indirizzo. State facendo perdere solo tempo.
Oh, that's funny. I thought this movie glorified sex trafficking. I loosen my tie at you.
Belle donne sono il paradiso degli occhi e l'inferno dell'anima.
Purgatorio per il portafoglio.
And dangerous to your fingers and your bed sheets.
Per un giorno che tutto questo sarà tuo.
Well, what the f- What the fuck? This gets me every time, directly after he tells him, oh, all of this will be yours one day, son. Right when I die, which would be 3, 2, 1, blow! Imagine this happening in The Lion King. Right after Mufasa gives Simba his grandiose speech, everything the light touches will be yours, and then Scar snipes him from Pride Rock. It's just a little too rushed, that's all I'm saying. We could have spent a little bit more time with the father and son, establishing their relationship. They shot him with store-bought tomato sauce! Prego! No, my friend. It's the generic kind from Walmart! No! Capo! Capo!
Telling me I'm free to go.
Oh god. Addicted to you. Right, so yeah, right after the father gets shot, we get a fucking love song. Totally not inappropriate. Like, look, I get it. It's technically a romantic movie. It's a dark romantic movie. But that's what I'm saying. It should be dark. Like, the opening credits and some of the music should match the tone of the film, and that does not match.
I expect a refund. And 5% interest.
It's impossible.
Refund and 10% interest. Until the end of the month.
This just fucking irks me. What gangster has to answer to a fucking bank or any financial advisors. I'm sorry. Step it up. You're the mafia.
My question is, how the fuck did it happen?
My question is, how the fuck did the director not ask for another take? What kind of shit?
This conversation is over. This is America.
This is America, where we badly dub our American actors.
It's all about word that you've given to my family. You have this game in America, right? Trick or treat.
It's not really a game, it's more like a tradition, a pastime. I'm just saying.
I thought that when it comes to sexual preferences, nothing would surprise me.
Especially being a character in this movie.
What would your loving husband say about that? Your kids, shareholders. Should I continue?
I know I keep reiterating this, but this is the mafia. Number one, they're doing business with banks. No. Two, like the most fucking violent criminals. We could threaten your families, burn down your house, blow up your car, put a horse in your bed, but no. No, here, we're going to release your nudes. That'll get you. We're going to release your nudes. It'll be all over TMZ. I swear this to you. I like this, like the back and forth between both characters to see how they both handle business. Giving a little insight into their personalities and probably how they're going to interact as characters later. Nice. Okay. Well, I can deal with that.
Every time you want to walk the door, I don't blame you. And I think you should know
that we need to fire our music guy. They're not together yet. Why the fuck should we care? Oh, titties bore me. You're doing work on a computer. Just get back to it a little later. And you disappear topless in front of the TV. Boom, problem solved. Y'all both fucking up right now.
Zresztą chyba jeszcze nas nie spakowałaś, prawda?
You don't fuck her and you lazy, nigga. Get out of my house.
Tylko no, żyje proza. Ilustra, container, la coca.
Hello? Cocaina? Cocaina? I care nothing for cocaine. Oh, the sex scene starts, and there's already atmospheric lighting. Like, no offense, but vibrators aren't sexy. It's the buzzing! It's the buzzing! It's just funny!
Ashes, we all...
Yeah. Really? The playground chant in the middle of a dual sex scene? Do we really want to go there? You see what I'm saying? Just too much music. It's to the point where you picked the wrong song.
Take me to the fire.
I'm sorry! First off, the camera's already shaking, okay? And he's like shaking her, like she's bobbing. And then he puts his hands on her head. So it's like her bobbing and him shaking her fucking head with the shaky camera. It's just too much. It's not hot anymore. It's just hilarious. And plus it's filmed like a fucking David Ayer action sequence. Just close up and shaky. Like it works for his movies, but it doesn't necessarily work for a blowjob scene. I'm just saying. I'm just trying to help. I'll give the filmmakers this. I'm giving points. The fact that they project the illusion of dick while not showing a dick, that's masterful. Gotta give him props. And the music, like why the music?
Najseksowniejszej, najcudowniejszej, najwspanialszej kobiety na świecie, czyli mojej mamy.
Yeah, see, he's a scumbag because he makes sexual jokes about his mom, and he's the only guy on earth who still wears starter. As evidenced by your starter tank top. I'm serious, like, who the fuck wears that shit anymore? And how, look how he's dressed in comparison to everyone else. He's the douchebag. We get it.
Are you lost, baby girl?
And here we come to one of the many problems with this film.
Baby girl.
Can we stop this? Like in all literary forms from present to future, please? Can we fucking stop using this nickname. I'll be sitting back, chilling, reading my favorite Henry Cavill Dom fic, Don't Ask, Shut the Fuck Up, and then he'll say baby girl and ruin the whole goddamn thing. I'm so sick of that word! And let's be honest, this dude does not sound natural saying it, because baby girl is a cringe American term. That is not in a non-American lexicon. You can tell by the way he fucking says it.
Are you lost, baby girl?
Because non-American people would not subscribe to such garbage. It seems like the author, because the author isn't American, the author is also Polish, the author maybe read it around in other American fics, and then she was like, oh, well, I'll use it. I'll use it in my shit. But it doesn't work, like, because you got your fic adapted into a movie. And now it doesn't work. It doesn't work. Ma'am, if you're watching, that is the most overused, tropey, cringy fucking nickname. And all it does is remind me of that meme that was out a few years ago.
Hi, baby girl.
And once I'm reminded of that, Sahara Desert. All day, every day. So yeah, that was my baby girl rant. And let's get back to the film. Even she is repulsed by his use of the word baby girl. Look at her. And he's got Batman powers. Like, whoosh. He's just gone. Oh my god. Like, I would break up with this nigga based on fashion sense alone. What the fuck?
Oczywiście, byłabyś zachwycona. Tutaj, słuchaj. Tu morze. Tam śnieg. Czad.
Nie pamiętasz, idiota, że mieliśmy tam pójść razem?
Like, they're supposed to go somewhere together for her birthday. And he forgot and went without her. What kind of fucking shit is it? Like, we get it. You want her to be with the hot Italian guy. We get it. Like, I get it. I genuinely get it. But Jesus Christ, don't lay on his dumb fuckery so thick. They come with bows and arrows. More pop music. Yay. Also, who is stupid enough to walk around a foreign country they've never been to before in a darkened corridor? Like, what are you doing? Where, how did you get there? And now you're kidnapped.
Buonasera.
Good evening. I am Man-Bun the Magnificent. I'm sorry, but her reaction is quite mild. I'd already be screaming and yelling for help. I'm in a place I don't fucking recognize after I was cornered in a darkened alleyway by some greaseball with a man bun. Hello? Is it registering that you're in danger?
Pardon.
Welp. And where did you come from? Where did you come from, Dracula?
Are you lost, baby girl?
Stop. Say that. Stop it. I'm not even.
Suck it.
He's gonna be saying that quite a bit in this film.
Suck it yourself.
Being so mean to me.
What I'm about to tell you is so incredible, I wouldn't have believed it's true until I saw you at the airport.
It was a dark and stormy night.
5 years ago, my whole life has changed.
Like, stop filming shit like that. The wide angle lens, it just makes things look funny.
My father died in front of my eyes. The bullet went through his heart and hit me. My heart stopped, I saw you. Every day I had this image in front of my eyes. Somewhere inside me I had this feeling of certainty that one day you will stand in front of me and be mine.
As romantic films in 2020 go, it's actually not a bad premise.
You must be kidding.
It's not that bad. He has a near-death experience. He sees his father killed right in front of him. And this image comes to him of this beautiful woman that comforts him and cradles him through this life or death experience. It's the last thing he has that keeps him together after losing the most important person in his life. And then, like, he cracks up a little bit, goes a little nuts, and he wants to find the chick because he wants that idealized version of this chick. He wants that comfort for real. It's not that bad. That's actually a step up from all the other fuck movies that we've seen in the past couple of years. But at least they're, like, being straight up. You're just mentally damaged, and you just want someone to comfort you, and that's about it. And it's very, like, dark story tale-ish. Like, it actually works. I'm digging it. I can go with it. I can go with this.
You can't have me just like that, kidnap me, and think that I am all yours.
I know.
Can't you tell by the sinister lighting on my grim face?
That's why I'm giving you a chance to fall in love with me. Not because I made you do it.
Oh, well, technically you didn't make her do it because you kidnapped her.
I don't need a chance for love from you. So I kindly ask you to let me the fuck out.
can see that the kidnapping got us on the wrong foot.
Your boyfriend doesn't deserve you.
Yeah, but he could have photoshopped that. I mean, it does kind of look like a bad Photoshop.
You know what? Fuck off.
I'm glad she kept the same energy. I'm glad she didn't just, like, just fold because her boyfriend cheated on her, you know? A movie from the USA would have done that would happen.
I won't do anything without your permission.
Except grope you like I'm doing now.
But don't provoke me. I can't be gentle. I'm not used to tolerating disobedience.
We get it. You're a mafioso dude. We get it. Imagine Tony Soprano being this blunt about his characterization. This family, I don't tolerate disobedience. My mother was not kind to me, and that's why I'm such an insecure blob of fluff.
You have 365 days.
He said it.
If next year on your birthday nothing changes, I'll set you free.
Bruh, how did you let this bitch disarm you? Are you serious? First you dealing with banks, and now you let this little tiny bitch disarm you? Bruh, you fucking up?
My estimation of
Massimo
as a man just fucking plummeted.
Do you really want to kill me? Many have tried. It's not that easy.
Actually, it's pretty easy. It's pretty fucking easy. I wonder what his consiglieres think about this shit. Oh, boss, do you think it's wise to kidnap a chick with a job and a family that could be asking where the fuck she went? And do you also realize that this could be a liability for our business and could attract the wrong kind of attention and could possibly distract you from things that actually need to be done?
Lo sto facendo. Il mio compito. Proteggere la famiglia e te anche da te stesso.
So he's kind of like Massimo's Alfred. I hope he doesn't betray him later in the series. A couple positives about this movie. One being the atmospheric cinematography. Like, it's really filmed well. Apart from, you know, blowjobs. But it's really nice looking. I fucking dig it.
So what father would be carrying me? Or tagliarmi le palle?
It looks like I already beat you pretty bad, bruh. You really want to provoke me right now? My kidnapped bitch is giving me trouble. Like, shut up.
Se tu mi avessi solo derubato, sarebbe finita così.
If you had just stolen from me, that would have been fine. No, it wouldn't have. Especially like old school Sicilian gangsters. No. But like, oh, see, he just wouldn't kill someone for stealing. He's a good man. Even though he was locked and loaded on the way down there. Why did you stop, dumbass? You heard a gunshot. Even he's like, oh, she's so fucking stupid.
How were you feeling?
Kidnapped.
It wasn't me who changed your clothes, it was the maid.
I just want to make that clear. I did kidnap you, but I would never change your clothes without your permission. It's one of death, man. Even though I kidnapped you.
So tell one of your butlers to bring my cell phone and laptop.
You will have your cell phone and your laptop when it's the right time.
We just have to delete TikTok off all your mobile devices. China's watching us, you know, it's not good.
I'm not a bag of potatoes that you can transfer without my permission.
You could have said package. I don't know why you said potatoes. Get him!
Domenico brought all of your stuff. Impressive amount of shoes for a 5-day holiday.
Women, am I right? Can't live with them, can kidnap them.
Today I have some business to take care of. You will accompany me.
I said I'm not going anywhere.
Are you sure? I take any opportunity to get away from that soundtrack.
Etno. Known also as Mungibello. The legend says that Zeus used to hide Typhon there. A monster of 100 heads that it's still trying to escape.
So Typhon didn't fall in love with Zeus in 365 days.
How dare you mock my mountain story! I wanna die. This music! I would forgive a shopping montage if it weren't for this fucking music. I feel like re-scoring this entire movie with other songs from movies that actually know how to build the atmosphere. Fuck!
Get out or else
I... Else what?
Or else I will name more Jordan Peele movies at you.
Or I guarantee you this is the last time you see it.
I've ordered it, and I'm gonna decide when I'm gonna see it.
Well, to be fair, he has a point. You know, you wanna get...
See it on yourself.
Aspetta.
She won't get far. She's wearing bricks.
Someone kidnapped me and I need help. Can you help me?
Buongiorno, signore.
Well, fuck.
Are you lost, baby girl?
It's they're making it a thing. No, they should never make that a thing.
Is it true what you said earlier, that you won't touch me without my permission?
I'm not the monster you think I am.
Maybe you are.
I want my cell phone and laptop and something normal for dinner. Pierogi. You made
a monster. She's such a monster asking for a pierogi. This monstrous behavior. The monster mash.
You look...
I'm starving.
You look starving?
Is it good?
My grandma makes them better.
You may leave, Chef Boyard dumbass.
So what do you actually do?
Thought it was quite obvious by my Italianness and my fancy suits, the castle I'm fucking living in.
The whole is part of a bigger operation, but the details are useless. And dangerous.
Those two words contradict each other.
I like you to teach me.
How to say baby girl without butchering it. Is the tender music warranted right now? Not really. I don't think we've been through enough development between these two for that.
Mamo. Tak, wszystko w porządku. Muszę ci coś powiedzieć.
I've been offered a new job as some Italian bastard's pump. Pays well? That is not a bullet wound. Come on, he was strong enough to go through his father and him, and he's just got like a little red pock mark on his stomach. Please.
Why are you looking at it? Do you want to touch it?
Of course! Say what
you think. Oh god, is the music for like blind people who don't know what's going on in the scene and they need music to spell it the fuck out? So fucking corny. Sounds like something Jeremy Renner can't. Sounds like some shit on Jeremy Renner's album. Like, no offense, Jeremy Renner. Like, you the goat. Promises.
Baby girl.
Ah! Oh god, I forgot about the baby girl part right there. Like, the neck grab was like, bam! The percolation has started. Then as soon as he said baby girl, it shot right back up! No! Why do people think that's sexy? It's not! It really isn't. It's not.
Don't provoke me.
Or what?
I'll do that jaw clench thing a few more times. I don't know.
You comfortable enough?
Jak mi tylko rozwiążesz makaroniarzu jebany, to zrobię ci taką jazdę.
English, please.
So problematic being racist to your captor. I'm not with that. It's 2020, bitch. Remember, I'm not gonna do anything without your consent except a little nipple tweaking. Hope you're okay with that. And some fingering, okay.
You have to earn the pleasure.
Excuse me, bitch. You kidnapped me. I'm a guest in your home.
Fratello. Cosa. Difficile.
Somehow women just don't like to be kidnapped. I don't know what the fuck.
Can you stop it?
Yeah, can you stop with the sexual cliches? Whoa. The lead actor is really, he's really something. He's in a hotel. It's not his house. He just has restraints, of course, because of course he does. I'm not gonna lie, that's a fucking iconic shot. Like, I can honestly see it becoming a meme, this fucking shot. I mean, the fucking filmmaking that goes behind hiding this man's dick. It's amazing. How did he do it?
It's a telescopic tube. Every time you move, it widens more and more.
Really?
I'm gonna show you what you're missing.
I'm gonna show you what they're missing by showing another chick blowing me. This writer is obsessed with blowjobs. I'm not hating, because I am too. Like, if you're trying to entice her, wouldn't you go down on the prostitute and give her, like, the biggest orgasm she's ever had to show her? Like, yeah, this could be you, bitch. But it's not. Because you want to act all disobedient, ho. And this fucking music! It's killing me inside! All of that him is just too much. I gotta say, this guy kills it. He knows how to convey passion and sexuality. If, compare this motherfucker to any other male romantic character we've had in the past few years, like Christian Grey, that little British twink from After. He's on another fucking level. Like, he's carrying this movie on his dick. And she's good too. The actress is actually good too.
Finish.
Keep me close to the cross. Keep me close to the cross.
I'm gonna fuck you so hard that they will hear your screaming war song.
Alright, but like, the weird thing about that line is whenever I hear Warsaw, I think of Nazis and Hitler, Jews, and devastation. Like, what the fuck, you're so hard, Hitler's going to rethink the Holocaust. He's going to rethink that whole shit. Honestly, they could have cut out that blowjob scene. Number one, it was pointless. Number two, it didn't make sense for the purpose of the scene. And it's just like, all you had to do was like, threaten her. Like, yeah, I can do whatever the fuck I want with you. And then do the kiss on the thigh thing. And then the scene is over. Booyah. It has the same effect as it would have had. Like, the blowjob thing just slows shit down for no reason. Somebody's whine, Mom. And look at this motherfucker. He's dancing to a completely different song. Like, dude, one of your many jobs is to keep the thoughts away from the mafia business. And you fucked it up. Anybody need some mafia movie authenticity? Oh god, dude even looks like a greasoid. Look at him. Ugh. Damn, you went double gun on him. How are you not a liability to the mafia?
You killed him.
I shot his hands. I wouldn't have to do it if you didn't dress like a whore and put on your little show.
So that's my fault that your friends tried to rape me. That's my fault.
He shot him in the hands? Like, you go back and forth with what you're fucking pissed at.
I'm so grateful that you're alive. But in the same time, I want to kill you.
Marriage!
Don't play with me.
Did you really think I'd just forgive and forget?
This, why can't it just be either fitting music or no music at all? Like, god damn it. And another blowjob scene. This writer clearly has a kink, and whoa!
Did you really just say?
I didn't notice that before. That is a lot. That is a bit much. Holy shit. What the fuck? Okay, wait. Now they're on top. They're like outside literally on the yacht. Fucking. And where are like his employees while this is happening? Like, did he explain this shit like they're his kids? Why don't you, Tony and Rodrigo, go down in the lower decks and go watch Teen Titans Go or something?
I just wonder if you're too tired for an evening surprise.
I'm afraid of your surprises.
Especially since your first surprise was kidnapping me. Oh, God. The movie has officially jumped the fucking shark. Oh, look, it's the wild and crazy guys of 2020. Yeah, he saves her life, they fuck, and now she's in love with him. Like, no more development needed. Oh, finally, music that actually fits the scene. Now you want to use the right music. Okay. These fucking movies like this always gotta have, like, a masquerade ball scene. It's becoming its own cliche.
L'ammazzo. Ti toglierò la cosa più preziosa che hai. Come tu hai fatto a me. What did she say?
Doesn't matter.
Oh, it kinda does. It kinda does.
I'm gonna light like fire. I'm coming down like rain.
What the fuck is this Sons of Anarchy title song sequence fucking music? This is another one of those sex scenes that don't need to be in the movie that could have been cut the fuck out. Could have been replaced with, I don't know, like a fucking conversation between the two characters to establish some chemistry something. Fuck.
Domenico, what happened?
They said the third act is going to be completely rushed.
You two are mine. Już myślałam, że cię porwali.
Hilarious.
Przy którym zawsze czujesz się jak mała dziewczynka. Jest spełnieniem twoich wszystkich seksualnych fantazji. A żeby było mało, to ma 1,90 m. Zero tkanki tłuszczowej jest wyrzeźbione przez samego boka.
You just described every male lead in every romantic book, Wattpad, movie. Could you not blow cancer directly into my face?
Who is tymi massimami martynami innymi mozzarellami?
This is so openly racist to Italians in this movie. It's hilarious. She took the news about her best friend being kidnapped by a fucking gangster very well. Like, unusually well. You take all the Italian jizz off your face. Why does her hair look like that now? She looks so dumb. Mm-hmm. You went from early 2010s Katy Perry to 2020 Katy Perry. That's a total downgrade.
Się przemyślałem, to i zrozumiałem, że masz rację. Pobiegłem za tobą, ale już cię nie złapałem. A potem cię szukałem, zrobiło się ciemno, wróciłem do hotelu i tam był ten list, ten twój list, w którym napisałeś to wszystko.
It'd be really cool if the story ended up like her really coming up missing and then him spending the entire fucking franchise trying to look for her. And then realizing, oh shit, I am a terrible... terrible boyfriend, but I'm gonna redeem myself by searching the world over for my girlfriend. And it would kind of mirror Massimo's and it would mirror Massimo's desperate search for Laura. Some people don't think of this shit.
You look stunning, baby girl.
You look stunning, baby girl.
It never gets better. I can't get used to it. Like I said, great cinematography. You can see his ball wrinkles from here.
This.
It's the herp, baby girl. It's the herp.
What's going on?
You kidnapped me?
I don't need 365 days.
Because
I love you.
If it weren't for the natural sexual and romantic chemistry between these two actors, this movie would fall apart like a dollar store TV tray.
Will you marry me?
Yes.
Oh, God, Christ. Will you marry me? You know, we've only known each other for what? I don't know how long. I don't know how long. The fucking time frame is fucked in this movie. And plus, we got another shopping montage. Oh, even Massimo is totally annoyed by where the direction the movie's gone in.
What do you want me to say?
I don't know. Improvise.
I mean, you improvised my kidnapping.
Mamo.
Stop being so worried about your child that inexplicably disappeared for an extended period of time.
My mom is asking, what do you do for a living?
I'm a gangster.
Really? You will be the first in our family.
That just rolled right off their back. What the fuck?
Here comes the thunder. Here comes the thunder.
And when comes the lightning? Because I want it to fucking hit me. Because all this music.
It's okay. I'm not hungry yet. I don't feel well.
When a chick says that in a movie where she's been getting piped up quite a bit, you know what that means.
I think you don't like me, Mario.
It's nothing personal. I don't like this situation.
I seem to be the only legit gangster in this film.
I will arrange your friend's arrival. I just hope she is calmer than you are.
Oh no, she isn't. That's gonna cause some hijinks. Bitch.
Ja po prostu nie wierzę. Pojebało cię. Wciąż jesteś.
Like Massimo, you fucking idiot. You didn't pack her birth control? You kidnapped her? You would look so much better in that dress if you had your hair from before, but now you just look dumb. This is so fucking rushed. They're already getting fucking married. Are you fucking kidding me?
Oh. How long does it take to try on a dress?
As long as it takes.
I miss you.
For once, I would just love a romantic movie where the girl changes her personality instead of the guy. Because I like Massimo in the first hour and 15 minutes. And then, oh, we're getting married and now I'm a soft boy. Ugh.
Vogliono uccidere Laura.
Sei sicuro?
Oh, God. Now I know what Junior Soprano meant by,
We don't run. It's embarrassing.
Laura? Laura?
They go into the tunnel, but they don't come out. Okay, that's a nice touch. I like that.
I'm on my knees in a $900 suit!
I mean, come on, we all know she's not dead. This is the first of, like, a series of films, so she ain't dead. So that is the movie. I got mixed opinions. I expected this to be like The Room bad from how people were dogging it. The two leads really sell this film because they're actually pretty good actors. The only thing they're really held back by is the material, which is, yeah, it's cringe. It's cheesy. It's fucking cheesy. Especially the last 40 minutes of the movie. Just that last 40 minutes felt so rushed. Like, oh, we're getting married now. We love each other. And she's pregnant. Like, what the fuck? Relax. Relax. That shit shouldn't come up until movie two. The real act of love would have been Massimo going in there and wasting every motherfucker who kidnapped her. And then they're on the run, and then we get some kind of development of their relationship. She starts to get to know him, he gets to know her, and then we develop some shit out of that. Like, there shouldn't be no fucking talk of marriage until the end of the second movie, in my opinion. But yeah, I mean, there's some bad acting in it, but it's mostly like side characters or people in the background.
How the fuck?
Some of the dialogue is really trash.
Stupid girl.
There are times where I commend the director for filming the sex scenes well, and then there's some times where they just look goofy. Shaky camera, why? Just why? You're filming it kind of like a porn, but also kind of like a like a David Ayer movie, like a war movie. Like, what? Why? But like, yeah, most of them are filmed really well. Some of them are really hot. Some of them are not needed. And the boat scene, it's just, it's not that it was gratuitous. It just went on for way too long. It went on for way too long. They were on the fucking yacht out in the open. Fucking, it's too much. It's too fucking much. Like I said, both lead actors are actually pretty good. But the one who really sells everything is the guy who plays Massimo. Like, fucking A plus from you. Like, an actor who actually wants to do well and actually gives a shit about the movie he's in. Look, I get it. Robert Pattinson, Jamie Dornan and them, they weren't happy about the crappy movie they were in. Oh, boo-hoo fucking who. You're getting paid. Like, what the fuck? And they just half-assed it. Like, I wish I could feel sorry for him for being so trapped, getting paid millions of dollars for basically doing a shitty job. Like, if you worked at fucking McDonald's, you would have been fired a long time ago. Stop whining. That turned into a whole other rant. But seriously, I can't stand when actors complain about how hard their job is, and then they have the fucking nerve to half-ass their job. It's so refreshing to see an actor with material. Like, it's not ideal. It's like, it's not high art, but he still gives enough of a shit to be the shit. Like, apart from like a little bit of like a little over the topness during the sex scenes, just like a teeny bit, but like he does a really great job. Can't deny it. The petition to get it taken off Netflix, it's even more ridiculous now that I've seen the film. Well, it glorifies sex trafficking, promotes abusive relationships. Like, fucking stop. Fucking stop. Like, you're giving this movie way more. It's like it's a Streisand effect. The more attention you give it, the more people are gonna fucking watch it. And then, on top of that, they're gonna know you're full of shit after they watch it. So stop it. Let the hype die down by itself. Oh, women are suddenly gonna think sex trafficking is cool if they watch this movie. Like, as if women are so goddamn stupid. They're so overtaken by their desire that, like, morality would just fly out the fucking window. Like, sex trafficking? That's fine. Even though the movie doesn't promote it, there's nothing in the movie really resembling it. I mean, it did its job for the most part. It's got two hot leads who have really great romantic and sexual chemistry. They pulled it off. Decent acting for most of the time. It's filmed really well. They actually made me give a shit about what's gonna happen next in the story. In recent years, like, it's fucking rare to make me actually give a shit about a franchise. Do you realize how much better this movie is than anything on Passion Flicks? The Protector. If you haven't seen my reaction of that, go check it out.
One day, I'm going to fuck you on this ancient tree trunk.
Oh my god! Anyway, that's my reaction. I hope you liked it. And of course, I have other projects coming out. Look out for part two of my Gotham High reading. I might be coming, I don't know when I'm exactly coming out with that, but I'm going to start working on it very soon. And I'm still working on that Dracula review. I am. It's just like this Gotham High shit is really getting in the way. But yeah, I love you guys. See you later.